يطير في الجنة مع الملائكة. I seen Jafar flying in paradise with the angels. The riwayat of Hakim Ibn Abbas says we were sitting wa Asma qareeba minna, and Asma radiyallahu anha was sitting close by. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ya Asma, hadha Ja'far qad marra ma'a Jibril wa Mika'il." Oh Asma, take solace, there goes your angel escorted with Jibril and Mika'il. The riwayat of Tabaqat ibn Sa'd, Abdullah ibn Umar says, "Kunna julusan ma'a Rasulillah sallallahu alaihi wasallam." We were sitting with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فَرَفَعَ بَصَرَهُ إِلَى السَّمَاءِ. He lifted his gaze to the heavens and then politely he said, وَعَلَيْكُمُ السَّلَامُ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ. So Abdullah ibn Umar said, I could not contain myself. I said, مَا كُنْتَ تَصْنَعْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. O Prophet of Allah, nobody greeted you. Who were you replying? He said, مَرَّ جَعْفَرُ بْنُ أَبِي طَالِبٍ فِي مَلَئٍ مِّنَ الْمَلَائِكَةِ فَسَلَّمَ عَلَيَّ. Ja'far has just passed by with the angels and he greeted me and I responded to his salam. I honestly don't know, and perhaps you can give me the answer. Was it the privilege of Ja'far to have a wife like Asma, or was it the privilege of Asma to have a husband like Ja'far? I guess you'll agree with me, respectively, both of them were favorites. After the demise of Ja'far radiallahu anhu, spot on 2 years after the demise, after her iddat was over, 6 months thereafter, on the occasion of Hunain, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam got Asma radiallahu anha married to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. That is why one amazing privilege of this woman is tazawwajat akabir as-sahaba. Her first husband was Ja'far radiallahu anhu. Her second husband was Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. This is an honorable woman, my sister. Not that youngster, his first car was this, his second car was that. Look at the privilege of this woman. Her first husband Ja'far, her second husband Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. On the occasion of Hunain, she got married to Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. And exactly 2 years after the marriage, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala blessed the union with a son. And where was the son born? This is something else. فَوَلَدَتْ مُحَمَّدًا بِذِلْ حُلَيْفَةً. She gives birth to her son on the journey of Hajj with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at Dhul Hulayfa. Now you want to read about some celebrity and some actress that has a child and she still has a slim figure, so she's a mother also and she's a celebrity also, and read about her, how she juggles herself between the fame that she enjoys in the world, and yet she's a happy woman at home. Well, ask her husband, how happy is he? Ask her husband. For me to say, you know, for a mother-in-law to say how good that daughter-in-law is, or for a daughter-in-law to say how good that mother-in-law is, it defeats the essence. It defeats the essence. Appreciate this woman. She gives birth to her child. Imagine the journey of Hajj with labor, with pregnancy. Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu is now confused. The Prophet said, Murha faltaghtasil. Tell her to perform her ghusl and don her ihram, and she's joining us for Hajj. And this child is born in the journey of Hajj. And what does she name her son? She names her son Muhammad. So let's not forget, she has 3 sons from the first marriage, Aun, Muhammad, and Abdullah. And she names her son from her second husband also Muhammad. So she names 2 of her own sons Muhammad, subhanallah. This was the intense love. And we say, no, we got a Muhammad in the family. So you got rich people in the family. Why you want to be rich? No, that's their money. So that's their Muhammad. No, in money matters, you know, we have it separate. That's their Muhammad. This is your Muhammad. That's their Aisha. This is your Aisha. A woman names 2 of her own children Muhammad. She performs Hajj with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. What more do you want to know? A woman that makes Hajj with her husband Abu Bakr, gives birth, and then Hajj with the Prophet ﷺ in the final Hajj. In the 11th year, when the sun of Nubuwwat sets and the Prophet ﷺ passes away, we can imagine the grief that every Sahabi experienced, and Asma was no less. Weeks thereafter, Fatima radiallahu anha calls her. Usudul Ghaba, the narration is there. Fatima radiallahu anha calls Asma radiallahu anha and she says, Asma, you know what? I am concerned about something. Now that my father is gone, and I think shortly I will move on. And we know Fatima radiallahu anha was the first to meet the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from the family. But I am very concerned about the preservation of my modesty at my funeral. What was the concern of Fatima? Not about the deco at my wedding hall. Not about how the photographer will come in. How the food, the trimmings and the draping and all the extras. I am concerned about the preservation of my modesty. So Asma radiallahu anha said, أَلَا أُرِيكِ شَيْئًا رَأَيْتُهُ بِالْحَبْشَةِ. Can I not share with you something that I observed in Abyssinia when I was there with my first husband, Jafar radiallahu anhu? A practice that I observed. So she said, please do. فَدَعَتْ بِجَرِيدِ. She asked for the twigs of a tree and she erected it. ثُمَّ تَرَحَتْ عَلَيْهَا ثَوْبًا. And then she put a cloth over it, creating like a canopy. And she said in Abyssinia, whenever a woman would pass away, we would observe this practice to maintain the bashfulness of that woman. So when Fatima radiallahu anha seen this, she was elated. She said, مَا أَحْسَنَ هَذَا وَأَجْمَلَ تُعْرَفُ بِهِ الْمَرْأَةُ مِنَ الرَّجُلِ. This is brilliant. This is phenomenal. This distinguishes the funeral of a woman from that of a man. فَإِذَا مِتْتُ أَنَا فَغْسِلِينِي أَنْتِ. Asma, when I pass away, I want you to be present at my funeral and I want you to give me ghusl and you maintain and preserve this. When Fatima radiallahu anha passed away, again Asma, this woman, was called on. Before my sister, you celebrate any woman's day, for Allah's sake, idolize the correct woman. Understand who this woman was. Asma was present and she gave ghusl to Fatima radiallahu anha. Not long thereafter, we know the reign of Abu Bakr was very short. When Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu passed away, again he made wasiyyat, his rest and his bequest, that ghusl must be given to me by Asma. فَغَسَلَّتْهُ بِوَصِيَّةٍ مِّنْهُ. Asma radiallahu anhu gave ghusl to Fatima. She gave ghusl to her husband Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu as well. She goes again into iddat. And after iddat, for a third time she gets married. And who does she get married to now? Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu. She gets married to Fatiha Khaybar, the fourth Khalifa of Islam, Ali radiallahu anhu. Her son Muhammad ibn Abi Bakr was only 3 years old at that time. And then we say, you know, I have persevered so much. Her son was only 3 years old. She gets married to Ali radiallahu anhu. In Tabaqat ibn Sa'd, there is an amazing incident that is mentioned. One day, while she was in the union of Ali radiallahu anhu, two of her sons had an argument. فَتَفَاخَرَ مَرَّةً وَلَدَاهُمَا مُحَمَّدُ بْنُ جَعْفَرَ وَمُحَمَّدُ بْنُ أَبِي بَكْرَ. كُلُّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمَا يَقُولُ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْكَ وَأَبِي خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَبِيكَ. Her sons had an argument. What was the argument? Now, how often when the children have an argument, then it becomes sensitive, the parents end up arguing, and then it strains the relation, and the wife feels that, you know what, you're not siding with me, you're siding with the children, or the vice versa. Appreciate the complexity of the situation here. It's two of her sons. The first son is from her first husband who is late. The second son is from her second husband who is late. It happens in the presence while she's married to her third husband. What is the argument? To add salt to injury, to compound the problem. Every one of the two sons are saying, I'm better than you and my father is better than your father. كُلُّ وَاحِدٍ مِّنْهُمَا يَقُولُ أَنَا خَيْرٌ مِّنْكَ وَأَبِي خَيْرٌ مِّنْ أَبِيكَ. So Ali radiallahu anhu said, اقضي بينهما يا أسماء. أسماء, your sons, your husband, sort it out. Generally, women, when the children are arguing, come see your children. Tell your father what you people are up to. And mashallah, when he excels in school or in academics, you've seen my son's marks. Brilliant, my sister, when he excels, is your